Have I changed these past few days? I don't think so. Have I altered my opinion? Not much. But... perhaps an attitude or two twisted in a new direction. If I'm going to ask myself some awkward questions about my attitudes when I started out, I'll have to use words like reluctance, too soft, unwillingness, too kind. Revulsion and loathing would describe it better. There was something in the image of the man that screamed against everything I regarded as classy. In good taste. The name Bles Bridges conjured up images of schmaltz, kitsch, non-art. Non-style, non-everything love songs. Come on, Deborah, tell it like it is. Hated the assignment. I thought the whole idea of writing on the subject of Bles Bridges, another bow in the direction of mediocrity. Now, let me remember correctly. I was doing the Collins story when Lewis blared one of Bles Bridges' songs all over the newsroom. Yes, I was doing the Collins thing.
Said it again, Deborah, darling. You're going, child.
I don't think so, Mr. Hart.
I wouldn't be so sure, Deborah. You know, when you're silly about something, you're silly.
Bles is all yours, darling. Have fun. It's not.
You've got to do it.
Not me, thank you.
Oh, yes, Deborah.
You.
Why? Tell me why. Give me reasons. Don't just stand there and tell me we must do it.
The public, the phenomenon, the readers, the arts editor going into convulsions every time he merely hears the words Bles Bridges, the women of the nation going soft in the loins every time he opens his mouth. Story, that's all I ask, not criticisms. Leave that to the arty-farties.
He's non-you.
He's got one hell of a concert in this town, Miss Martin, and that is a story. And where precisely is he so non-you? Among your arty-farty friends?
Oh, come on, Lewis.
This is a daily in the service of the people. I want a full-page spread, in depth. Find out what makes him tick.
Why me?
You've got a week to do it. You can take Sam with you. And tell him I want it sentimental. Plenty of romantic, soft backlighting, that sort of thing.
I don't want to do it.
Look, Deborah, you have done stories about murderers. Why not Bles Bridges?
People deserve to be murdered. Music doesn't. Sam!
Yeah?
You're on your way to the sticks.
Who too?
Bles Bridges!
Bles Bridges! Wow!
If I were a writer, I'd write you a beautiful love song. If I were a singer, I'd sing it to you too. If I were a merchant, a handful of diamonds.
Turn that damn thing off.
Just to prove to you.
You said I can...
I know I said. just can't take any more. Only a very ordinary man can live in this place. Turn left over there.
Why do you hate him? You haven't even met him.
He stands for bad taste. I hate bad taste.
I like him.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to...
No, never mind.
You haven't met him either.
But I want to. You don't.
That must be his place over there. Boxing and golf. And that one was for Businessman of the Year. Oh. Is he nice to work for?
Don't mind me, Anne. Tell him the truth.
I wouldn't have followed you from the oil company if I didn't like working for you.
I know. She's my conscience, Miss Martin. Yes, Mr. Davis. I don't care what you do. As long as you deliver it on time. Okay, thank you.
Shall we start the interview while we have tea?
I've spoken to your news editor a moment ago, Miss Martin. Your newspaper's art page has been tearing the skin of me for months. And I thought the sudden interest rather strange.
Oh, did he tell you?
What do you think about me? No, Miss Martin, he didn't. These things I know without telling. Hello? Okay, just hold the calls, okay? I'm busy. Okay, thank you. No, Miss Martin, he suggested that you stay over at my place for the night so you can meet my family. He also said that is an order, not a request. I invited you both, you see.
But I have commitments.
He said you should treat the whole thing like a murder case. Whatever he meant by that. So you're staying. You can talk to anyone about me, but not to me. Yes, Alfred.
He's done it again, Mr. Bles.
Let me see.
Will you please check the wording, Mr. Bles?
You know better than I do. But these things are not fit for pigs, Alfred.
I told him so.
And what did he say?
He said... No, I'm not going to tell you, Mr. Bles. The devil will come out again.
Then I'll find out for myself. Mr. Davids, will you look after these people, please? Nobody, but nobody's going to treat my people like this.
Keep the devil inside, Mr. Bles.
Mr. Bridges!
Have such trouble with that man.
No. No, don't go. Tell me about him.
Madam, with respect, if you're one of them, I'm not talking to you.
One of whom?
All the women chasing him. Because... Just because.
So... There I was, accused by this Alfred of being a member of the Blessed Bridges fan club. One of those women who lusted after him. Or something. A because woman, according to Alfred. And Alfred was something of a mystic. Curbside philosopher.
You see, he's got this song in his heart. Here, up. I tell him so to his face. Natty, Mr. Bless... You've got this song in your heart. Hmm? What do you want the devil for? And the because women. Hmm? Goba, they hear the song calling. Hmm? And they don't understand it. But Mr. Bless won't listen. But the other devil. We don't talk about the other devil.
Have you known him long?
Yebo. I saw the song grow inside him. Me, Alfred. The sad one and the happy one. Huh? When he was nobody. But Miss Leonie made his heart sing. Beat off my heart. Me, Alfred, I was standing by the gate. He sang that day. He sang so sad and so deep. I watched the car.
Beat in my heart. With every breath you bring your love to me. Beat in my heart. Love changes facts of life to fantasy. The silver moon up in the sky and stars like candles in the night will shine for my love and I until we part. Beat of my heart. Beat of my heart. At last the loneliness in me has gone. Beat in my heart. Two hearts together will now be just one. And this will be the reason why our love will live until I die. For me
you sing so beautifully.
Thank you, Mrs. Thompson.
Get me.
And love forever holds the key.
He was young and he saw her once. God love everything. But the old man did not like Mr. Bless. He told me so himself. When he went there, the old man looked right to him. You don't look too, Mr. Bless. Not too long, anyway.
I'm Lemmer, Leonie's father, if that means anything to you.
I'd just like to ask you, sir, if Leonie could come dancing with me.
Something but like to ask, isn't it? She's already dressed, so why ask me?
I'm sorry, sir, but I didn't exactly have the time to ask your permission.
Well, I didn't exactly have the time to give it, did I? She'll be down in a minute.
I'm sorry.
He doesn't like me, what?
He's afraid that he's all wrong.
Tell me.
Well, if I do, it'll sound strange. Kind of forward.
What?
Please try and understand. You see, he's scared that I'm gonna get mixed up with some guy and I won't finish my medical course.
He's got a point there.
Meaning what?
You are in danger of doing exactly just that.
Think a lot of yourself, Mr. Bridges.
No, not me. I never dream of such a thing for myself. I'm thinking of my handsome brother.
Well, if he turns her head, I'll just have to send him on his way.
sing.
Oh, come on. Sing? But for a living? You mean professionally? Can you sing?
I can sing. I know it.
Well, everyone I know who thinks they can sing can't.
Let's sit down. Tell me,
do you always judge people before you know what they can do?
I'm sorry.
Tonight when I came to your house, your old man treated me like, you know what. We dance and I feel the togetherness. And now when I try to tell you about something I feel inside me, you almost laughed at it.
I didn't realize that you took singing so seriously. You're so self-confident.
I must tell you two things. One, I shall sing. Two, you are a medical student, I'm a fitter and turner. But we both are people. And we both know it. And let's put three there as well. I prove what I am and what I feel. And please. I want you to remember for as long as we know each other. When it comes to singing, I hurt easily and I hurt deeply.
Thank you for the rose.
I shall keep it.
The rose won't last too long. It's what you feel inside that you can make grow and last. Or you can deny it and make it a little by-the-way memory of a certain Bles Bridges that sang your silly old song one night at the dance. Just be honest.
You seem to know how I feel. Why don't you be honest?
We have a long future to talk about.
That, then, was the beginning of the romance. According to Alfred. But I was getting worried that I was stuck with Alfred forever, because Bridges didn't return from his potato chip mission.
That's my Mr. Bles. He wants something. He goes for it. Quick, quick.
I'm sorry if I kept you waiting, Miss Martin, but there was an emergency.
I've heard your whole love story from Alfred. Is that blood on your waistcoat?
It was an accident, Miss Martin. I had to take somebody to hospital.
Serious?
I hope not.
It was the devil.
We don't talk to other people about the devil, do we, Alfred?
We don't, Mr. Bles. I shall go now.
Okay.
Excuse me.
She smelled a story.
No, Sam. She smelled blood.
You don't like journalists.
I love all people. I just don't like some of their traits. Let's go.
Alfred! Alfred! Wait! Please, you can tell me. I won't publish it. Just tell me what the devil is. Alfred, wait.
Oh. Miss, when Mr. Bles says don't talk about the devil, you don't talk about the devil. Even if the devil himself wants you to talk about the devil. Imali, Tinde.
Come and be Miss Martin. Sam, you can follow us.
I just wanted to ask Alfred something.
He'll tell you everything you want to know, Miss Martin. As long as you don't offer him money in exchange for his loyalty to me. That is a mortal sin around here.
Disloyalty is a mortal sin around Bles Bridges. And then I met Leonie. His better side, as Bles puts it. The one who ought to know him. That kind of thing.
Mrs. Bridges.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Tell me how it all started. Well, you're a woman. You know that I'm not going to tell you about the... Well, what should we say? The beautiful little... Precious, is that the word? I try not to be overly sentimental. The night you came back from the dance. Yes, the night we came back from the dance. I was so young and so in love. My father wanted me so much to become a doctor. He had his heart set on it. That's normal. I understand him now that I have children of my own. Yes, I think it was the first time that we heard each other.
You've decided to come back, after all.
I'm sorry it's so late. I didn't realize that you'd still be up.
Who is this Bridges?
Oh, is this a friend? It was our first date.
What does he do for a living?
He's a fitter and turner. And he also sings in places.
Oh?
Yeah.
He sings, eh?
Yeah.
What's he sing for? Tobacco and guitar strings?
No.
Leonie?
Yes, Dad.
Leonie, you've had a good third year, and I'm not going to let you waste it. I would do anything to give you a good start in life.
I am grateful, Dad. But why don't you just once give me some love? Some warmth, some understanding, instead of all this ambition.
Leonie, all I do for you is done with love.
But from such a distance.
Bridges. By the name of Bles.
Good shot. We were young and we were poor and we were so normal. You know how it is when you're young. You think so easily of forever. And forever is today. And when you fall in love, you think it's the first time anything so uniquely beautiful has happened. Ever. But with us, we had to face some difficult decisions. Bles is always in a hurry. Always. But then you don't know him. I'm getting to know him. I still underestimate him, I think. We danced and we pushed that old anchor. And we laughed.
Thank you.
If I spend the rest of my life with you, I'll be the fattest girl in town.
Most probably. But I promise you, you'll drive the biggest, slickest, most expensive motor car in town. And you'll live in the second biggest house. I promise.
Why don't you rather face my dad? Promise that, too.
He'll still be awake if I know him at all. Come, let's go. Ask you something, sir.
Please listen, Dad.
I am listening.
We love each other, sir. And we'd like to get married.
He just stared. I'd say it was 20 minutes. Bles says it was an hour. I don't know. It felt like weeks. And when he spoke, it did hurt. Because today I know he meant well. He...
So you want to get married, eh? On what? What will you live on? A Fitter and Turner's weekly pay packet and a couple of cheap songs? And where will you live? And Leonie? She'll have to work. With what? A matric? And her wasted years at university? Do you really expect me to give my consent to you two? Leonie, I expected you to qualify and become a doctor.
and to find a husband worthy of you.
Sir.
A noble listener.
No.
I'm going to marry her, sir. I love her, and she loves me. And I'll be worthy of her, whatever you think of me.
Well, if that's the kind of man you are, the quicker I put a stop to this business, before you ruin her life, the better. Good night, Mr. Bridges, and don't come back, eh? Go to your room, Leonie.
Would you say your dad was right? I understand your question. I mean, look around you. I'm sorry. You're a guest in my house, Miss Martin, and I have tried to be as helpful as I possibly can. You seem to be fishing for something, which I'm afraid you won't get from me. I love the man to distraction. He's done everything he said he would and more. I didn't mean to imply... Hi, Dad. This is Miss Martin, the journalist who's doing the article on Bles.
Hmm, good evening. Bles told me you were here. Lemmer.
Sam.
We were just talking about you and Bles in the beginning.
Is it really necessary?
I like to get as full a picture as possible.
Did you really oppose the marriage so strongly?
Yes, I did. One doesn't know how a man will turn out, does one?
And?
Well, I had ideals for my daughter. As far as I was concerned, Bles was a half-Irish fitter, looking like every other ducktail, driving a motor car he had to push half the time. And according to reports, he had a devil in him. Badly.
Everybody talks about his devil, but nobody wants to tell me what it is.
Well, we all have a devil in us, don't we?
Which one has Bles got?
Well, an Irish one.
Which Irish one?
Dad.
Yeah.
I have to go out. You'll be well looked after, Miss Martin. Sam. I hope to be back soon.
Yeah, I hope everything works out okay.
So do I.
Go on.
See you later. Okay, bye.
Is something wrong? You look concerned.
Yes, I am.
Is it something I may know?
No. It's between Bles, myself, and his Irish devil. Now, can I freshen up your drink?
And there the story dried up. There was a song in Bles Bridges, according to Alfred, and a devil, according to Alfred, Leonie, and his father-in-law. An Irish devil. That was the story. That was the scandal. That was the soft underbelly every journalistic instinct told me. But suddenly, the blanket fell, the clamps clamped, the mouths tightened. I had to go elsewhere the next day.
Do you remember Mr. Bridges well?
Don't talk about him. Bring him back.
Why?
Why? Best bloody organ salesman in the business. Came in his overalls. I didn't want to take him on, but he barged in.
But where are you going, sir?
He's got a job for me.
Hey, you can't go in there. I'm so sorry, Mr. Dawes. I told them.
Yes. What do you want?
My name's Bles Bridges, sir.
Oh, yes, yes. The air conditioning's over there.
Do you want me to fix it?
Well, it hasn't been working for a long time. Why do you think I called you?
You didn't call me, sir. I'm here for the salesman's job.
In overalls?
Oh, well, I got fired in overalls, and I'm here to apply for the job in overalls. I'll be your best salesman, sir. Do you want me to fix the air conditioning in the meantime?
Yeah, fix the damn thing. And then you can go to the accountant. You're hired.
Why?
You'll either be very good or very bad. And if you're bad, I'll fire you. Either way, I can't miss.
You scored the bullseye, sir. I'd like to know my employer's name. You didn't tell me.
Tell the others outside the job's been taken. And my name is Dawes.
Thank you, Mr. Dawes.
And suddenly we had money in the house. Bles sold organs like it was going out of fashion. And then when they made him manager, he went to the oil people. Well, that was before he started his own business. He worked 25 hours a day. In the meantime, he sang all over the place, but with little success.
I love you as high as the sky is above you. I don't even my thoughts thinking of you. And I know how I love you. Day by day I'm drifting all alone.
They didn't want his songs. The record companies were wary.
That I could go my own. Till the very day I found you, and you let me stay around you. Then I knew my heart had found a home. I love you.
Suddenly someone decided to take a chance for the recording, and he rushed through the recording sessions. Worked himself to death. His stomach was acting up more than he ever let on.
Love is all that.
Try it again tomorrow.
No, I want to do it now. I feel better. Come, let's go.
Are you sure?
Yes. We've got to finish these recordings on time, man.
Please, you must go and see a doctor.
When the recording's done, then we've worked hard for this to let it slip now.
Mr. Bridges, in my consulting rooms, I prefer honesty. I want my patients to know the truth. Now, much as I may be able to help you, it is you who will have to cope.
So, you have bad news for me? An operation?
Well, if it comes to an operation,
That'll be good news. The results so far are not encouraging. There is a cancerous growth, and there's a very good chance the cancer may have spread. And in that case, an operation is... You'll have some very big decisions to make, Mr. Bridges, and you will have to trust me. Now, I consider it part of my job to help you in any way I can, not just medically. Your reaction is silence. That worries me.
Do you want me to tell you what I'm thinking? I'm thinking how much I love my wife. Is that strange?
No, it says a lot.
It's sad. I wanted to sing. I worked so hard. I was getting somewhere. I was conquering this devil in me. And I learned to love people in a general kind of way. And now it's all going to be taken away from me.
You must understand two things, Mr. Bridges. One, the situation is serious. But second, there may be a small chance that the cancer has not spread.
If there's an outside chance, I'll fight.
I know you will. I think you ought to tell your wife. But if you do, don't leave her without hope. And don't give her false hopes either. Just leave it somewhere in between. Hmm? I'll talk to her if you like.
We've shared some hardships together. And we've shared some success. We will share this as well. We have that kind of love, you see.
I envy you.
But first I have to work it out inside.
I remember. Miss Leonie said I must go and find him.
At work.
But he wasn't there. I drove up and down, up and down.
Oh.
Look at me. But I don't think he looked at anything that night.
In the end, I want to live love.
Let me show you that I know that love will be all that I need. Let me love you. Let me lift you. Let us live not to receive, but to give. All my tomorrows depend on your love. I know that every stranger is a friend. My hopes are as high as the sky up above. Love is all that matters in the end. I want to live love. I want a love life. Let me show you.
You want to get yourself killed? No. I don't want to die. I don't want to. Take me home, Alfred. Where's my car?
You give me such trouble, Mr. Bles. Sometimes. But I see your song is very sad tonight. Come, let me take you home. I wanted to tell you, life is a song. I wanted to say to Mr. Bles, everybody is a song. But some songs, they can stop halfway. Like me, nobody will notice. But his song must finish.
Where have you been?
Just hold me. Hold me and let me listen to your breathing. It hurts less when you hold me. And it hurts more because I love you.
Do you want to tell me?
Let the words wait for a while. They can come later.
Whatever it is, it can't be the worst. We've got much to be thankful for. Mr. Thomson was here today. Mrs. Thompson's got cancer. She was your first fan, remember?
Yes, she was my first fan.
Leonie did not want to talk about the illness. She just didn't want to recall it, I think. Came out in the smallest of fragments.
Are you a missionary or something, Reverend?
I have a mission, if that's what you mean. All the people I meet are my mission, my daily mission.
So now, at this moment, I'm your mission?
You must be, otherwise we wouldn't be here together.
But we just landed here together. It could have been anybody else.
It could have been, but it isn't. And I believe there's a reason for it.
You really believe that?
Yes. I believe there's a reason for everything.
I wish you could give me a reason why I'm here.
Why should I be able to?
But you said...
The fact that I said there's a reason doesn't mean that I know what that reason is. Are you afraid that your illness will stop you from doing something you wanted to do?
Yes.
And what is that?
I wanted to sing.
Sing then!
I'm in no mood for singing. Why should I sing when every second person is dying? What is there to sing about you anyway?
If you only want to sing for the healthy and the beautiful, and the rich and the cultured and the learned, then you have a very poor song in you.
Alfred always said, I've got a song in me.
Alfred may well be right. But don't you think the dying deserve your song?
Mr. Thompson, how are you?
That's what I have to ask you.
I don't know yet. How's my oldest fan? Leonie tells him she's ill.
Your first fan, not your oldest. Bles. She's dying in the ward next door. Can you come and see her? She'd very much like to see you.
Do you see now, Mr. Bridges? Our need for human warmth is the strongest when we are alone. And dying is a lonely thing.
Yes.
Would you like it if I sing one of her old favorites?
You know she'd love it. She hasn't much left.
My guitar's in the boot of my car. It's standing right in front. Will you fit it for me, please?
Do you think I have to ask permission?
No, they both need the song. Perhaps all three of you need it.
Liked each other, Mrs. Thomson, and you've always had faith in me, and I want to thank you for it.
Don't thank me. Yes, thank me, please.
You and Mr. Thomson used to hold hands in the garden when I was practicing this song, and nobody was looking.
Then I know which song it is.
I've wandered today to the hill of Maggie to watch the scene below. The creek and the creaking old mill, Maggie, as it used to be long, long ago. The green growth is gone from the hills, Maggie, where first the daisies sprung. The creaking old mill is still, Maggie, since you and I were young. They say that I'm feeble with age, Maggie. My steps are much slower than theirs. My face is a well-written page, Maggie. And time all along was the best. They say we have outlived our time, Maggie, as dated as songs that we sung. But to me you're as fair as you were, Maggie, when you and I were young. They say we have outlived our time, Maggie, as faded as the songs that we sung.
But to me you're as fair as you were, Maggie, when you and I were young. When you and I were young.
Yes, so did I.
And you've lost a song and you've gained one. Songs are for ears, not only for mouths.
This morning I wouldn't have understood it. Now I do.
Was that perhaps why?
Must be. You make me believe in reasons.
You already do.
Something happened. I'm not afraid anymore.
What were you afraid of? Death?
Not only that. Leaving you behind mostly.
I'd never allow that. Now, Deborah, my darling.
Deborah?
Is this sheer stupid, sloppy sentimentality in its worst form? Are we all sentimental when we feel in this particular way? When we're in love, dying.
Davy. Les Bridges.
He then had a successful operation. 75% of his stomach was removed. Before the operation, I was told he sang for some old people in the ward. Mark? Is that the truth? Clinically, yes. In human terms, there was a woman.
I want to live.
Together when we're apart.
Say it's a non-story.
Of course. Because I've even heard of this cat Bridges. Can't do a story on every cancer patient in every ward.
Well, I only asked because the man does have a record to his name.
Not much of a record, I'm afraid. I'm going to kill him off anyway.
Is he that bad?
Worse. Not the type who can spear even damn with fine praise. You'll get nowhere.
Let him have his cancer in peace. I listened to part of the record before coming here, Lewis. He'll never make it big. Never.
Hart?
Look, that kind is better forgotten. We don't want to stir up a publicity storm on a nobody. Not on my art pages, anyway.
Okay, okay. We'll leave it. I was just checking.
We didn't run or even write the story at the time. And I gave the man Bridges, by then bald from therapy. Not another thought. Not even when I read Hart's stinging lines on the quality of the record.
You don't have to keep looking at it. It won't disappear. How do you feel? Proud?
It's what I wanted to do. I've done it. The people out there will hear me. Yes, I'm proud.
Why don't we play it?
It's all I've done the whole morning.
They've got a photograph of you in here and of the record cover.
Let me see it.
It's not nice.
Why not?
What they're saying.
What do they say?
That you'll never make it, and about your voice and your presentation and other things. I don't want you to read it. It's not true.
Listen. We're going through the worst anyway. Do me a favor. Leave me alone with this thing for a while.
Why alone? I'm with you.
I've told you once. When it comes to singing, I hurt easily and I hurt deeply. I don't want you to see this. Please respect that.
Okay. I respect it.
Okay. Taken it off the shelves.
Let's find out.
Excuse me, miss, ma'am. I'd like a copy of the Bles Bridges record.
Forget it.
What do you mean, forget it?
Sold out. Came in yesterday, was gone this morning.
Did Mr. Bles tell you where he was going?
He didn't say. His eyes told me not to ask.
Oh, well, he must have gone somewhere.
If he heads, he will go to the old house. And if he's happy, he'll go to the horse.
Then you must go and look at the old house, Alfred. I want to be here when he gets back.
He does not think he's dying. Is he?
In a way, yes. Yourself.
No, it's difficult to get out on a diet.
Oh, my darling. You're going to kill yourself. Those people, they're not worth one minute of unhappiness.
I've never been so happy in all my life. Come, get in, I'll tell you.
So, that was history. Love, engineering, and singing success. Yes, with the people. Not with the critics.
The big concert was coming up. At the entrance of Bles Bridges into the big time of acceptability. But there was more. And for that I had to find the devil.
Where did Mr. Bridges disappear to that night? And did he ever come home? A mistress. In the early morning he was supposed to be with his racehorses.
Like this snooping thing. Why do you want to spy on him?
Because I haven't got a story yet. Just follow him. Step on it, Sam. Don't let him get away.
Do you really think I can keep up with that job in this piece of tin?
Do you think I want to go back and tell Lewis I couldn't get one bit of juice out of this clean-living, wife-loving, non-swearing businessman of the year singer?
So what? He's a nice man.
No one. Is that nice?
Come.
He disappears every night to some meeting.
So what?
His wife worries about him. His father-in-law talks about the devil. And his sidekick, Alfred, is holding thumbs day and night about something.
I don't like it.
You can always say you wanted to take some mood shots, Sam. You know, early morning, mist, horses against the horizon. He's in one hell of a hurry.
That's for sure.
Interested. Well, at least we know there's something fishy going on around here.
give you a hand, Mr. Bridges.
Thank you, Sam. I'll manage.
We just wanted to get some early morning shots.
You can always portray me as a delivery boy.
You've got so many people working for you. Why do you deliver, what, vegetables and milk in your flashy car?
Personal things are done personally, Miss Martin. You better not follow the dog.
We might as well have breakfast, Sam. We can come around later to see what she looks like.
Morning. Mrs. Perreira.
Still the same. Still the same.
Nothing yet?
Nothing.
I brought you some milk and vegetables.
You are so good to me.
I'll pick you up again at 7 o'clock tonight. Is that what you want?
I shall be ready. Perhaps tonight he will speak to me. I shall pray.
Perhaps tonight.
I want to know. I've got a right to know. We're less than a week away from the most important concert in Bess's career, and I'm not told what's eating him. He's told you. I know that.
Leonie, it's between Bles and me. Now, if you want to know something from Bles, then you must ask him yourself.
Well, if he's in trouble, I know how to find out.
Thanks, Mrs. Frayland.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Excuse me. Good afternoon. Can I speak to the young woman who lives here?
No young woman living here. Sorry, you speak to me.
But doesn't Mr. Bridges visit somebody here?
Mr. Bridges, he brings me the vegetables and the milk every morning.
Why?
You, his wife. I'm old, the ugly. See, I'm old, the ugly. No young woman living here.
But why does he deliver the vegetables? He's a rich man.
I don't know his money. He'd take me to the hospital. He has a nice car. But for me, I am too old. Mrs. Bridges, you don't have to worry for me.
To hospital?
It's my boy. He's too sick. I pray every day. I pray what I do if my son, he doesn't wake up again. So I pray.
I'm sorry to have troubled you.
You come here and you buy nothing. You ask me strange things. You have a good husband. A very good husband.
And so, for the umpteenth time, I was called one of Bless's women. Albeit his legal spouse this time. But the devil evaded me. The mistress, who had to be somewhere, didn't materialize. Then there was the stroke of genius, which will be documented in the dossier of my eventual fame. The hospital. I was shocked by the prospect. To use an old woman and her sick son as an alibi to visit some nurse. Hello, Mr. Thomson.
Oh, Leonie.
I was just worried about Bles.
Well, he has been here, but he had to go to the hospital.
The hospital?
He didn't say much. He said it was urgent.
Right. Thanks, I'll come and visit you soon. Bye.
Sick man, Miss Martin.
The one who had the accident the day I met you.
Yes.
Did you have anything to do with it?
The man is very ill, Miss Martin. Why don't you keep this out of the way?
I thought you were at a meeting.
Leonie.
the devil, wasn't it?
Yes. I just couldn't bring myself to tell you.
Oh. But the press was welcome to it. Don't you realize that you're a public figure now? That you can't afford the devil anymore? What marvelous publicity this journalist is going to give you for your concert. I don't think I can cope with two devils at a time. Your wife is upset. Shouldn't you go to her? I can take the lady home.
From the beginning of our relationship, we abided by a rule, never to be together when we're upset. We've saved a lot of hard words that way. She knows I'm sorry.
What is this devil?
The same one that's in you, Miss Martin.
Me? Explain.
When I can trust you, I will. But I still think you have nice legs.
Bles is always right. Nothing he does can be wrong in your eyes. Just as he could do nothing right in the beginning. He should have told me.
It was his decision. Leonie, he wanted to spare you.
If anyone hears what he's done, there'll be no concert, no singing, no Bles Bridges. Actually, now that woman, and the press to stand there where the man lies, it's...
Aren't you underestimating your husband tonight, Leonie?
No, I'm not. He promised me he'd leave the devil alone.
Yeah, you are underestimating him. You worried about a concert? He's out there praying for the life of a man.
Yes. A man. What happened to him?
I hit him.
Why do you sell this muck to my people, Perreira? I told you 100 times, if their money is good enough, they at least deserve decent food. These chips aren't fit for pigs.
Your people are pigs.
What did you say?
Your people are pigs, man.
My people, pigs.
You always say things like that. The blood! The blood! Do something about the blood! It gets in the oil!
That's what happened. That's the Irish devil.
Doesn't the old lady hate you for it?
She knows her son.
You realize that I can hang you with this story?
I do. If you can't control your devil, you will.
Why do you say we have the same devil inside?
Sometimes when the devil comes out, I hit someone without quite realizing what the consequences might be. That's assault. I hate it. You sometimes assault people's reputation with your words. That's the same perversion.
I beg to differ.
When you publish my story, you'll know. You can break my reputation with it, if you want.
Do you realize how big this story will be? Popular singer kills Portuguese.
I don't care about my reputation. As long as the man lives. I didn't mean to kill him. It's a life. I've almost lost mine. I know it's worth.
Why did you tell me? You don't trust me.
I trust you until you drop me.
I won't spill the beans before the concert.
Do as you like. It's not the concert. It's a life.
I was sitting on a story at last. The naive. The naive trust of the man made it difficult. I couldn't bring myself to go to the concert, under the circumstances. Why did I hate the people streaming to the concert? Why did I? And why did I decide to drive all the way to see a Portuguese man in hospital? To check my story, finally, I told myself.
There's only one thing that has to turn out well for me. It's life. I don't want to take a life. It's too precious to me, every moment of it.
Stage call in 2 minutes, Mr. Bridges, please.
Thank you, sir.
Looks good. Sing well, man.
Crossing to the Civic Theatre, where Bles Bridges is to appear on stage any minute now.
Day, be all the
It was to hold happiness in my hands. For the first time, I knew it. It was urgent, and it was beautiful, and I drove to the concert.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to dedicate the next song to an old Portuguese lady with a heart full of forgiveness and to a man I didn't particularly like and to the death of a devil. In fact, two devils and to life.
Cold winter's morning, at the time I was gone, as a new day was dawning, life was loving and warm, and the song that I heard was a sweet lullaby, but that day was the first time I cried.
I have conquered the day. In my heart with a song, with love in my mouth, I can never go wrong. Whenever the devil tries to drag me along, I will listen again to the sound of the song. Whatever was lost in my life to stop, I will find with a song in my heart. Day after day,
as my life away.
Song in my heart.